Good morning. It's a pleasure to be here on this morning after, especially after yesterday's storms. It's quite an event today. We are here to have the official dedication by the commissioners, local fire officials, of the latest regional fire protection water storage facility. In essence, it's a 30,000 gallon underground water storage tank that supports a local fire department in their firefighting efforts in the region. And we'll pause for a second as some traffic goes by. Again, the pleasure to be here, and we're going to, no further ado, I'm going to introduce some of the folks we have here to make this dedication happen. First, I'm happy to say we have Commissioner Roush, Commissioner Rothschild, President of the Carroll County Voluntary Emergency Service Association, Mr. Steve Lance, and Chief of the First View Fire Department, the New Windsor Fire Department, Chief Tom Coe. And at this time, I'll turn the podium over, I believe, Commissioner Rothschild, who had some comments.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you, Scott. I think it's important to point out with this event that this is an example of government doing what it should be doing, example of our emergency services people working with county staff, Scott Campbell and his group, who manages emergency services for the county to protect our citizens. And what this tank is, it's a regional tank. As you know, we have very limited water supplies in Carroll County. We don't have reservoirs. And by putting this underground tank here, we provide additional fire protection for our citizens, their families, and their homes. And I want to congratulate and thank all the people in our fire department. I want to thank Scott Campbell and his organization and the county government. And on behalf of all citizens of Carroll County, thank you for doing this. This provides us with protection that we need. And with that, I'll turn it over to Commissioner Roush.
Thank you, Commissioner. This is a wonderful day and a terrific installation. But I especially want to thank Randy Myers. He's the property owner here, and he made this all possible by donating a piece of land on which this tank could be placed. And it is citizens like Randy that go a long way to making Carroll County the wonderful place it is to live and work. And I want to thank him very much for his efforts, for his willingness to be a part of this project. Thank you very much, Randy.
Thank you, Randy.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Randy. Thanks.
Okay, now we're going to have just some comments from the fire service. President Wance, you would like to say something?
Just briefly, I'd like to, first of all, thank the county commissioners for their support as we identify the areas that need these regional water sources. We've got quite a few that are in place already, and we have identified places where we need some additional. So the support and the working relationship we have with them is priceless. So thank you very much for your support. Certainly thank Scott Campbell and his office. Again, they were instrumental in identifying this, working with Randy, and making sure that this got completed. I know there were a few loopholes and a few hoops to jump through as we got this placed and in service. Scott was instrumental in making sure that happened, and certainly I would like to thank Chief Coe and the New Windsor Fire Company for being a part of this also. This is their first due district, but keep in mind we identify this as a regional tank, so certainly the location of this tank is important, as several fire companies, Westminster, Pleasant Valley, Union Bridge, all will be able to take advantage due to the location here. So, again, thank you to the commissioners, to Scott's office, and all the folks that were involved with this, including the folks that installed this. Thank you very much, and we look forward to getting a few more of these in place. Chief Coe?
I'd like to echo the thanks on behalf of the New Windsor Fire Department to Randy Myers and his family. For without him, our 10-year search for property for this fire protection tank would not exist. Today's a big day for Uniontown, as this area is not unfamiliar with conflagrations. There's been several significant fires in this area, and all of them have suffered from a lack of available fire protection water supply. So this is a new day for the Uniontown area, and their citizens can rest well, better protected with this tank in place. I'd like to thank the commissioners for their assistance in bringing this project to fruition, and the folks at Condon's Excavation, a local company that was able to do an excellent job in putting this tank together. Thank you.
And now, I do believe in giving credit where credit's due, and a lot of names were mentioned this morning, and I hear my name mentioned a lot, and I'm going to be very candid. This would not have happened if it weren't for the talents and the efforts of a member I'm fortunate to have on my staff, Brian Van Fossen. Brian's a fire protection specialist with our office, and there is absolutely no question that this came to fruition as well as it did because of his efforts working with the other folks that we've already heard. So, Brian, a personal thanks for making this happen. And now we're going to get to the main event, and that is a ceremonial ribbon cutting by the commissioners to officially place this facility in service. Okay. Are we ready?
Yep. Wait for me.
The rest of you get to work.
Let's do a countdown, gentlemen.
Three, two, one,
cut.
Cut.
Nice job.
Beautiful.